Paradise on 95.3 K-Rock. It's 7:10. You're listening to the Chris and Smoke Show, brought to you by Value Master Home. 16 degrees right now, cloudy out, looking for a high of 20. Showers ending around noon, and then a 30% chance of showers and a risk of a thunderstorm clearing late tonight with a low of 10. Now, join us in the studio. Are a couple of the ladies from the Lakeland Ladykillers roller derby team. Now, I'm going to give you their real name and then their roller derby name. First, we have Terry Cross, who is known as the Naughty Newfie. And then we have Laura Carbonell. I hope I got that right. Did I get that? Carbonell?
Yep.
And her name is... her roller derby name is Pepper Longstocking. All right. Welcome to the show, ladies. Tell us about roller derby. First off, you know what? And guys are probably the worst about this. Guys think about roller derby, women skating around, little skirts, clotheslining themselves, clotheslining each other, and just getting into, fights. And,
yeah.
we're like, well, that sounds like a pretty good sport to us, but really, it's not about that, is it? Tell us about what roller derby really is like.
Well, for starters, it's a sport first and foremost, so, and we're really big on promoting that. Yeah, we still do kind of wear short skirts and all that fun stuff and fishnets. It's a little bit about having a bit of an alter ego, and we haven't lost that aspect of it.
Yeah.
But we don't, we're not out there to beat each other up for entertainment.
Right.
We're out there to play a sport, and there's rules, and it's structured. And a lot of the what appears to be skimpy outfits is actually quite practical, because we work up a really hard sweat out there skating around and trying to get points for our team.
Okay, now saying that, how does one win? What are the rules of roller derby? I just see that everybody's skating around in a circle.
Yeah.
What exactly is going on?
Well, I think I'll let one of our star jammers answer that.
By the way, that was we're going to get into your name in a minute. That was Naughty Newfie speaking, but now we're going to get to Pepper Longstocking. Pepper, tell us a little bit about how it all works out, and get right on that microphone. I need you right up there.
Yeah, absolutely. Each team is composed of four blockers and one jammer. The blockers start first, and each team skates together. The blockers are trying to stop the opposing jammer from passing and help their jammer get through, and the jammer gets a point for each person that they pass. So basically, the jammer's trying to skate around as fast as they can, and everyone's trying to knock them down.
Now, this is actually quite a physical sport, right? It's like, this isn't just doing laps around a track or anything. There's a big physical element to it, right?
Yep, absolutely. There's conditioning, so you do have to have the endurance. You have to be able to sprint. And there's also, it's very much like football or hockey, where there are checks that are allowed and blocks that are allowed.
Okay,
and
yeah.
Places where you're not allowed to check your blocks.
So you can get penalties for interference or, knocking someone too hard, a hip
absolutely.
Check or something like that. No hip checks?
No, hip checks are allowed.
Oh, that's excellent. We like hip checks.
But you can definitely, there are a few things you can do that can get you thrown right out of a game. So you do have to be careful that you're hitting legally and properly. You can't hit anybody else to the back.
Okay.
You can't hit anybody else above the shoulders.
Okay.
You can't hit anybody below.
So kind of like no cross-checking, no elbowing.
What about headshots?
Headshots.
No headshots?
No headshots.
Okay.
There's even a specific rule in the rule book that says no choking someone with their helmet strap.
Yeah.
Maybe we can get you girls to demonstrate on smoke what's not allowed. Like a couple of headshots, maybe a shot between the legs, whatever.
I don't want to get beat up this morning, and I'm pretty sure you guys will both
want to
take
get beat
me
up by two girls.
Well, you guys will take me pretty easily, I think, too.
I don't think that'd be a problem at all. All right, well, I guess the big thing is now you've got a team here. You're going to be playing a team down in St. Albert, but what you want really is a number of ladies to join this so you can have teams in-house here in Cold Lake. Is that right?
Yeah, for sure. We're out looking for new recruits, or as we like to call them, fresh meat. And
I'm not even going to go there. Right? That's Naughty Newfie talking. You've understood how she got her name. Okay.
And so we like to call them fresh meat. We're looking for a group of girls that'll come out, and you don't really need to have any prior skating experience. We're willing to train right from scratch. We take all shapes and sizes, and we take all skill levels. You don't need to have a lot of previous sports experience. Some of our girls have no sports experience and no skating experience, and they're some of the best girls girls we have on our league currently. So we're looking for a group of girls to come out and try out, and we're going to put them through boot camp. It's going to be a 12-week program, and they're going to learn everything they need to know about derby. And we're hoping to get enough out this time that we can have a house team. We can have house teams, and then we can put on bouts for the community, and they can come out and see what we're all about.
And this is an adult league. What are the ages that you look for?
It starts at 18, and it goes up as high.
To 97.
If a 97-year-old is ready to get strapped on the stage.
Granny,
man.
There's a hip granny that can throw a hip without throwing a hip out. You would take the granny.
For sure. Okay. If they're physically capable, they can come on out and try. It doesn't matter their age or their previous skill level.
So we got to ask you guys about the names. So Naughty Newfie and Pepper Longstockings.
Yes.
You got to tell us. How do those names come up?
Do you want to start?
Well.
Okay, Pepper Longstocking, what happened?
We each get to choose our own names, but it is an international. You have to basically claim that name. So you have to submit it to a website that's worldwide, and you have to get it approved. So we all just kind of think of it, and we each have to choose our number as well. So we choose something that means something to us. We have one girl whose number is 39, because that's when she started, and when she was 39 years old.
Good for her. Wow, all right, right on, man. And Naughty Newfie?
Well, my first choice was actually taken by somebody... I don't know where, in California or somewhere. And my second choice was actually, I wanted to call myself the Newfie Bullet, which is anybody that is from Newfoundland knows that that's a train that existed in Newfoundland for a while. And so that's the one I wanted. And some girl in Toronto has that too. So then... So I picked Naughty Newfie because, well, I'm obviously very proud of my Newfie heritage, and I'm trouble, so.
All right, well, okay, we're going to go with that. And the first name you picked, is it radio-friendly? Are we allowed to bring it up?
Oh, yeah, for sure. Yeah, it's the first name I wanted was Punky Bruiser.
Very clever. Very good.
And I do leave my fair share of bruises, the girls know. I have a wicked shoulder check.
Oh, jeez, wow. Well, I tell you, you know what, hearing about it, sounds like a lot of fun. I definitely would not want to get it on the rink with you girls. And I was going to ask one quick question. The roller skates, are they the old style of roller skates, or are they the...
They are. They're four wheels, so they're quad skates that we skate with.
Is that ever cool, man? I think that's totally cool. Now, if someone wants to get involved, who do they get hold of?
Well, right now we have an email address that they can email. It's generalinquiry at lakelandladykillers.com.
Okay.
And we're actually hosting two info nights. There's one in Bonnyville on Monday the 27th at the Bonnyville Curling Rink. It'll be from 7:30 to 8:30. They can come by, and we're going to give them a little presentation on what derby's all about, what they need to do to join, and then have a question and answer period where they can sign up. Okay. And we're also not just looking for skaters, we're also looking if there's males out there that are interested. Males cannot skate with us, but they can be our refs, and and they can participate that way. And we also are accepting NSOs, which is non-skating officials, so people to keep track of penalties, things like that. They can also join that way. And then we're also hosting one here in Cold Lake in the JJ Parr upstairs in the cafeteria. We're hosting that one on July the 5th from 7:30 to 8:30. Same thing. We're going to give them a little presentation, and then they'll have a chance to answer some questions. And if you want to come out and see what it's all about even before you come to the info night, we're allowing the practices are open to the public. We're skating right now in the JJ Parr on the Red Rink Tuesdays and Thursdays from 7 to 9 and Sundays from 2 to 4. You can come by, drop by, check us out, and watch what we're all about. And then after practice, if they have any questions, they can definitely ask us. And a lot of times we'll go out, you know, for a few sociables after practice or whatever, and they can tag along with us. And
Typical new thing. A few sociables. Yeah. A few sociables. Okay, interesting. Well, you know what? It sounds great. And you know what? I think you've dispelled a lot of myths about roller derby today. And I think you've probably piqued the interest of a lot of ladies out there. I hope so, because it sounds like something that's a lot of fun and keeps you fit. And you know what? Get out there and enjoy and meet some new people.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks so much for coming in, Pepper Longstocking and Naughty Newfie. All right. You girls have a good day. That is the Lakeland Ladykillers. And if you would like more information, you go to LakelandLadyKillers.com. It's all about their roller derby. Bonneville Curling Rink on this Monday is info night, 7:30 to 8:30. And if you want to get out to Cold Lake, July 5th at the JJ Par up on top there at the cafeteria, 7:30 to 8:30. Stop on by and find out more about it. The ladies will be there. You can even stop by this Sunday, 2 to 4, and watch them play and see what it's all about.